one day I was actually with Mr. Aditya Birla, and he was talking to his father, Mr. B.K. Birla, over phone, and they were negotiating on some commodity which is called pulp. You may recall that Mr. B.K. Birla has his own empire, he runs his own companies. One of the company, Century Textile, actually produces a pulp, and which one of ABG company, Indian Rayon, uses for its own as a raw material. And to my surprise, they were both were really kind of haggling on the price. They were negotiating very, very hard. And after a while, when they kept the phone down, in my own way, I asked Mr. Birla, why were you haggling with your father at the end of the day? This is between the family only. I distinctly remember he going back on his chair like this, and he said, Sushil, you are right, but you know, we both were doing our part of job. He is responsible for separate set of shareholders, and I am responsible for separate set of shareholders. To me, this was a big learning. In 1990, in my mind, the corporate governance world didn't even exist. But I'm sure, but I know for a fact that group must be even practicing this governance way before 1990. And that's why possibly group is known for strong corporate governance. It was late 1995. Mr. Kumaramanu Birla had just taken over as a group chairman. We had taken a legal opinion from a reputed law firm in the country involving two of our group companies. One was on listed side and another was on a private side. The law firm actually had raised the bill in favor of a listed company. Since I was not sure, I had sought Mr. Birla's view on the subject. This matter remained pending for a couple of weeks, and one of the Saturday when we were cleaning up our old many matters, I brought up this subject to him, and he also wanted to talk. He said, Yashil, I want to talk to you on this, and he asked me calmly that who benefited the most from this opinion. I took a couple of seconds and I think I got my answer, and we ended up debiting that invoice to the private companies. In my early days, this is another learning of governance, and I understood the concept of trusteeship through this lesson. There is a very thin line of difference between organizational success and failure, and that thin line is people. People are the most important asset of any organization. Therefore, it is very crucial for any organization to attract and retain the best talent. Your competitors can imitate products and acquire assets and technology, but one thing that they cannot replicate is a committed workforce. There is no standard recipe for the growth. It all depends on your own hunger and reflects from your daily behavior. As a group, we have a formal appraisal system where we appraise every employee twice a year. However, I would say we actually get appraised daily. Right or wrong, whatever we do gets noticed regularly. Sometimes the recognition can take a little longer, but it always comes. I believe no one has got it right. Work-life balance is a state of mind and differs from person to person. For me, if I am comfortable doing my work and while performing my duties, can be available to my families when needed, I have met my work-life balance goal. I believe family plays the most important role in one's work-life balance. My wife Anita almost single-handedly raised our children, managed our family and home, yet never complained. Rather, she supported me throughout as I was performing my duties. I totally agree when they say, behind every successful man, there is a woman. my early learning I got from Mr. Adit Birla was, if there is a bad news, always try to get it first. Encourage a culture where people are not afraid of giving bad news, as it gives you a slightly longer time to resolve the problem. I keep encouraging my colleagues not to be scared of bad news. We should not fret about what is not in our control, but work on what is in our control. This is the same with the boards and the investors. The investor always look for a bad news upfront. They don't like surprises. If someone is a long-term investor, they would appreciate our belief and conviction. On our part, we have to reflect the conviction that you are fair, honest, and right in your action, because this is something that is in your control. Mr. Adit Birla would always tell me, Sushil, likhi. And sometimes I used to get irritated about this. But then gradually I realized the importance of writing things. It forces you to think systematically and explore all angles of the problem. Mr. Kumaraman Birla also encourages us to write. Keep your work simple and short. Everything around us is very simple, but we overthink, overdo, and make things complicated. My advice to young professional would be to work on sharpening their analytical skills and be able to differentiate between the letter and spirit. Or they say substance over form. We talk about building a successful career. A person should equally focus on developing people's skill. And remember that a successful leader stands on the foundation of a highly effective team. One should be sensitive to emotions and think from others' perspective before making conclusion. Learning should be a continuous process. One must always be open to suggestion and have the courage to accept failures. One should be confident of one's action and ensure it passes the headline test. One has passed the headline test when he has the courage to stand up before a crowd and take ownership of the things done, and that he has acted in the best interest based on the circumstances prevailing at the time of action.